Good morning. Happy Sunday. I'm coming to you to do my Promise Cruise Essentials video. I don't want to call it a pre-cruise haul. I kind of don't like the word haul because it suggests excess, like just more than what you need. But I have gotten a few essentials. Most of them are things that I already had that I just wasn't using, which is why I don't like to do hauls, because we usually have stuff lying around that we just don't use. But in any event, I digress. We're going to do cruise essentials. I am not an experienced cruiser. I've been on one cruise prior. So what I'm sharing with you is the things that I wish I had or known about on my first cruise, as well as I devour YouTube for all the great tips that the very experienced cruisers have been on. So this is a compilation of that. It is by no means the Bible on cruising. It is just the things that I know will keep me and my children comfortable while we're cruising. So let's go. In no particular order, a pharmacy bag. When you're on a cruise, I do know that things are very, very expensive. Basic, ordinary, everyday needs are very, very expensive. So in this little bag here, I have just basic medications that should something happen while we're on a cruise, we can take care of it. Cold, allergy, headache, diarrhea, don't act like y'all know, it happens. Anti-nausea, which I don't have in here yet, but I'm going to because I am prone to seasickness. So that's a must for me. And when you have kids, stuff happens, like they get colds out of nowhere, and you don't want to have to either not have it and they not be comfortable, or be forced to run out and buy it in the ship store, because you know there's no Walgreens or CVS, so you're gonna pay a ridiculous price for something that you could have easily just brought from home, because all of this is stuff that I already have, and they're just a variety of things: band-aids, antibacterial ointment, you name it, it's either in here or it's going to be in here. So I'm gonna put that down. Okay, the next thing, hangers. They don't give you enough hangers. I mean, even in hotel rooms, for the most part, they don't give you enough hangers. And they especially don't give you enough hangers. You might have enough hangers for you if it was just one person in a stateroom. But if you have more than one person, the 6 or 7 hangers that they give you are not enough. So get you a pack of hangers from the dollar store. A dollar. That's it. You can leave them and donate them. I mean, I'm sure they won't keep them, you know, because they clean the rooms and they'll get rid of them. But, you know, who knows? Pouches. 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 I have pouches. I have pouches. I have lots and lots of pouches. Pouches are not a problem for me. But what their purpose is to help keep your bags organized. So these pouches are going to serve a variety of purposes. Not sure exactly what at this point, but they're going to serve a variety of purposes of things that will be needed. A waterproof holder for your smartphone. This thing is really, really great. It gives you a little peace of mind, because if you want to carry your phone with you while you're in the water, it really and truly prevents water from seeping in, and you can still use it. You know, like, it's not just that, it's not like a Ziploc bag. A lot of people use the Ziploc bag because it's cheap, and that's fine. But the problem with a Ziploc bag is that you can't use your phone for the most part. I can fully use all the functions on my phone. Now, you know, it may be a little, not even difficult, just not as easy as just not having it covered, but at least your phone is protected. And that's what's important. It's protected. The next thing, a door sign. Yes, a door sign. I did not do this on my first cruise because I didn't know that people did this. But once I went, I saw that people had their doors decorated. And then, of course, I've been looking at YouTube videos and Pinterest, and people decorate their doors and they be doing the absolute most. I am not doing the absolute most. However, I will do a little door decorating, so that we can find our door, because it is, now I will admit that it's just a sea of doors, and sometimes, you know, it takes a minute for you to get to yours or even recognize yours, so having it decorated will help you find yours quicker, as well as, I'm just extra like that. You'll come to know this. So, I'm going to decorate my door. The next thing. I've never done laundry. However, I have a 9-year-old daughter. And things happen when she's around. So, while I do not think I would actually go to the laundry room to do laundry, I've been in there, I don't think I would actually do that. But if I needed to rinse something out, and in fact, I wish I had had detergent. And by the way, this is laundry detergent, since I'm doing all this talking. She got sick on our cruise. And if I recall, I had to throw all her things away because it was no way for me to rinse them out, and she got really, really sick. So if I'd had detergent, I could have saved those clothes and at least gave them a basic washing and put them in a bag until we were able to get home and I might not had to throw them away. So don't think that laundry detergent doesn't come in handy. It just might save you. Next thing, a roll of duct tape. I personally have not ever needed duct tape. However, I do see the value of how it could possibly help you. And, you know, I'm not doing plain old duct tape. Y'all don't really know me, but you're going to get to know me. I'm not doing plain old duct tape. We going to do some gold duct tape. And what's next? Mosquito repellent. I'm being eaten alive now as we speak. I live in Florida and the mosquitoes are hungry and they're looking for whom they may devour, and I will not give the island mosquitoes any new food. So I have some mosquito repellent. I do not have the one that has DEET in it. My daughter has eczema and my skin is a little on the sensitive side as well. So I'm a little cautious about using the one that has DEET in it. So this one is the lemon eucalyptus, and from what I've been reading, having eucalyptus is just as effective as having the DEET. So we're gonna go with the more natural alternative to keep the mosquitoes from eating us. Mosquito repellent, gotta have it. And what's next? These are badge holders for your sailing sign or your sea pass, whatever cruise line you're going on has a name. I just have a bunch of them because they were like less than $2 at Walmart, and I already had the actual string for the lanyard. I had a couple of them lying around just for various reasons. They just didn't have the badge holder. And this I do wish I had on my last cruise, because putting it in a bag and every time having to keep pulling it out and going in your room, and that was getting on my nerves. So as much as I really don't like having stuff around my neck, I'd rather have this so that it's easy and accessible, opposed to having to keep going in a bag to get it out. So get you either the whole lanyard set if you don't have it, or get a badge holder or something to keep your sailing sign or your CPAS card in there. And what's next? Sunscreen. Yes, I'm African American. Yes, I'm already tan, as you can see. But I burn. And if you really look closely, you can see tan lines because I have been in the sun, and I won't say I've burned, but I've been in some really, really hot sun. And the Florida sun doesn't play games, and the sun in the Caribbean doesn't either. So, sunblock, sunscreen. I use it. I put it on my children. Like I said, my daughter has eczema and my son is very fair skinned for an African American. So he browns easily and she burns easily. So we have to protect ourselves. So her dermatologist recommended water babies because it's less harsh for the skin. So we have water babies. And now, I don't remember really, really needing this last time, but everybody swears by it, some type of room freshener. So I'm going to bring a spray as well as just one of the ones that you just, you know, open it up and sit in your room to keep the room smelling fresh, because number one, you know, no fresh air is actually getting in because the windows don't open. And number two, the bathrooms are very, very close. And, you know, bathrooms don't smell the nicest. So I'm going to just keep this in the room so that the room overall smells Hawaiian fresh. And I have a lot of stuff in here, but some things are not really essentials, so I don't want to pull them all out. Aloe vera gel, that is an essential. It helps cool your skin down after you had a lot of sun and makes it feel better. And it will save you if by some chance you do get burned. So I do have a little bit of aloe vera gel. I don't think we would need more than this. Okay, here we go. Water bottles. Aren't they cute? These are for the kids. 98 cent Walmart. The cups are so small. I had forgotten that until people started talking about it. The cups are teeny tiny. Like, who are you giving to drink? Babies? So, water bottles. They can pour their juice into the bottle and have something to walk around with. They don't have to keep getting refills. When we leave the ship to go off and to walk around in port, they can fill it up with some water or whatever, and they have something to drink. So bring a water bottle. I'm bringing one too. Mine just isn't in here right now. Try to get a water bottle that has something so that they can attach them to backpacks or bags or anything so that their hands will be free. I'm sorry. Clips for whatever, but primarily they're so big because they are to clip your towel to your chair. Now, a friend of mine had some really, really cute ones, and for her chairs, because, you know, like I said, we live in Florida and we're always at the beach or the pool or whatever, and I couldn't figure out what I could do to keep my towel from flying away until I saw hers, and I was like, what is that? However, I don't want to spend like $10 or $12 for the real cute clips. These dollar store giant clips will work just fine. If you could see, you know, they have a very large opening. I don't want to take them out the bag because it'll make it easier to pack. So a dollar, they will work just fine. No, they're not the cute flip-flops, but it will do the job. And this is another part of my door decoration. It's a hanging garland. Yes, I'm doing all of the most. And hand sanitizer. I know ships have hand sanitizer everywhere. However, I like my hand sanitizer because it smells good. This is vanilla coconut, and I also have some from the Honest Company that is an orange scented that is absolutely delicious smelling. So I will be bringing that and this, and hopefully that will get us through. I might have to get another one just in case, so that we can make sure that our hands are properly cleansed. Carabiners, these are to hook anything onto anything that you might possibly need. I actually got these just so the kids can hook their water bottles onto their backpacks, but you can use them for anything that you might need to hook something onto. I'm trying to make this quick because I know you people like quick videos. Clothespins. I do remember that they had a clothesline in the shower, and just draping your wet things over the clothesline is not going to get your stuff dry the way you need it. So clothespins, a dollar from the dollar store. This will help you. It can close the window in your room because that window doesn't close all the way. And you have some light coming in at a time when you don't want light coming in, because I have an ocean view room. And let's see, a pop-up hamper. That is an essential because it allows you to throw your dirty items into a hamper, get them out the way, keep them separated from your clean stuff until you're ready to go. So, a dollar. Nothing here is expensive, and everything here is something that can be reused again. Suction hooks for the bathroom. I know everyone talks about that there are not a lot of places to be able to put things at. You can attach this to the wall in your shower to put your washcloth, your shower puff, whatever it is that you need. And I already had these. I didn't even have to buy them. I had them because I used them. I actually used them in my own shower. I'm trying to be quick because I know y'all don't like long videos. Need I say more? Clorox wipes. We got to wipe everything down. We got to keep it clean and sanitized. We don't want to be sick on the ship. We don't want to be sick when we leave the ship. So I do this in hotel rooms. I do this on the plane. As soon as I walk in, I put my stuff down and I start wiping. So we have Clorox wipes. And along with the Clorox wipes, we have some disinfectant spray. You know, can't be too careful. A sleep mask and some earplugs. I don't anticipate using them because I don't like to be that insulated when I have my kids around, but if the noise level got just way too much, they will come in handy. I'm almost done. Almost done. Magnetic clips. I did not know this then, but I know now that the walls are made of metal and you can clip things to the wall instead of laying things on the desk. So it gives you more surface room. So I have magnetic clips. Aren't y'all so glad that I'm giving you this information? And then I have great big strong magnetic hooks to hook things that are a little bit heavier that you would like to have hung up to save space in your cabin. I'm gonna hook y'all up with all the tips. Some downy wrinkle releaser, because you can't bring an iron. And I remember that my ex-husband had to take all of our clothes and he would go to the laundry room to iron everything every night before dinner. It was a huge, huge pain. So I am going to be packing differently this time to make sure that no ironing has to be done, because I'm not doing it. The wrinkle releaser will help greatly. I did not have that at the time. I'm prepared this time. And, you are allowed to bring a bottle of wine per adult for your stateroom. So you need something to open it with, a corkscrew. And I had this. This is my own corkscrew. So, you know, because Royal Caribbean charges a corkage fee. So if you have to ask them to open your wine, they charge you for it. That's not happening, y'all. Either I'm gonna get a screw top or I have my own corkscrew. And post-it notes, brightly colored, so that you can leave messages for your cabin steward and just say hi, have a great day. And a pen and a highlighter goes along with that so that you can highlight your activities for the next day. And some command hooks to be able to do that door decorating, because they don't allow tape, because the tape can damage the surface of the door. So you have to use either command hooks or it's something else that you have to use, and so that it'll just peel off when you're ready to go and it won't cause any damage. There are a few other things that I consider cruise essentials that I don't have here, because either I don't have it readily accessible or I don't have it yet. Like, I'm going to get not a power strip, because I understand that some cruise lines are not allowing you to carry power strips aboard anymore, and they have only one or two outlets in the whole cabin. And while I have very short hair, so I don't need hair tools, I do have electronic devices, and my son has electronic devices that he's going to need to charge. So I'm going to get one of the ones that a USB charger, which I think they will allow those. So I'm gonna have one of those, no power strip, and there might be one or two other items that I consider essentials, but that's it. So I hope this has helped you in some kind of way, and this is what I need to be comfortable on a cruise. You can take some of these ideas and use them for yourself. You can add to it. You can say, I don't need none of that stuff. I just want to get on board. Do you? But in any event, thank you so much for watching. I appreciate having a little bit of your time. I hope this video wasn't too long for you, but I do long videos because I like long videos. I like to watch people who give me a lot of detail. 5 minutes is really just not gonna cut it and give you all the information that you need. So I appreciate when people are very thorough, and I wanna be as thorough as I possibly can. I will be back in another day or so with it's too early for me to pack, because I'm still like 50 days out, I think, for my cruise. But I do have my things assembled that I want to take. And so the next video will be what to take on a cruise. Yeah, since we can't pack yet. We'll do a what to take on your cruise. What type of clothing, accessories, shoes, all that kind of good stuff. So I'm going to stop talking and I'm going to let you go and enjoy your Sunday. Have an awesome, awesome day.